Hi, my name's Ollie. I'm an Autodesk certified instructor, and today we're just going to do a quick video on how to create a gear to insert into your assemblies or your designs. Now, there are two main ways to insert a gear in Fusion. The first is you can use the Spur Gear add-on that will allow you to create a custom gear that you can then use in your design. Or if you want to use a standard gear from a manufacturer, you could insert that manufacturer's part and the 3D model for it. Now, that first one is creating a custom gear. And to do this in Fusion, we need to use the Spur Gear add-on, which we can find from the Utilities tab at the top of the design workspace. You can then go to the Scripts and Add-ins, and down at the bottom, there is an option for Spur Gear. When we click on this and press Run, it will open this Spur Gear add-on box. You've got a helpful diagram at the top if you're not familiar with gears. But generally speaking, you can then go through and you can adjust the different settings that you want for your gear to custom build whatever it is that you'd like. You can choose from imperial and metric dimensions. And ultimately, once you've decided on your gear, you press OK and it will model that gear for you. Now, when you're doing this, all this is doing is it is doing a step-by-step process to model this gear. So it's adding the gear as a component in your browser. And if you look at your timeline, it's grouped it, but if I open that group, you can see the modeling steps that have been taken to create this gear. So if you really wanted to, and the settings that you were being given in the Spur Gear add-on box weren't sufficient for you, you could go through and edit these, or you could follow the steps to fully model it yourself. However, like I said, we can also insert a 3D model of a gear. And this is particularly useful when we're using a standard off-the-shelf gear that we're trying to buy for our company rather than actually custom make. Now, inside the insert menu at the top, we have a few different options for how we can insert parts directly in Fusion. You could also try and find a 3D model of your gear externally and import it. But here we have trace parts, the insert and manufacture parts of parts for CAD, and McMaster Carr, which is what I'm going to use here. Inside McMaster Carr, I could search for gears or different types of gearboxes. I can then do filtering based on the type of gear I want, the diameters, the number of teeth, etc. And once I've picked a gear that I'm happy with, I can click on the product detail and make sure that my dropdown is set to 3D step. When I do this, I can press the download button, and that will insert that as a component inside my design. Once it's been inserted, it is just the 3D step file that's being inserted, so I'm not able to go through and see the Fusion details and edit them in the same way as I could on a different gear, but I could still use direct modeling techniques or draw my sketches and extrudes on top of this to be able to adjust my gear if I wanted to. So for example, I could go through here, I could do a tangent plane on the surface, and then maybe I could create a hole on that surface. Now, like I said, ultimately you could just follow the steps and completely draw your gear yourself if you wanted it to be custom. The process is relatively straightforward, but those two ways are going to be the most useful aspects for inserting a gear into your assembly or your design. Hopefully you found this video useful. If you did, feel free to give it a like, add a comment if you've got any questions or follow-ups, and I look forward to seeing you in the next video.